Friends, today we are going to learn about height and distance. And if you are studying about height and distance, then you must know about trigonometric function. And that trigonometric function will be start knowing by drawing a right angle triangle. So in a right angle triangle, this is a right angle triangle where BOA, this angle BOA equal theta. So this particular angle is theta, and based on this right angle triangle we'll know what are the trigonometric ratio which is possible. So we'll see that what is sine theta. Sine theta is nothing but perpendicular by hypotenuse. So this is perpendicular, AB is perpendicular, hypotenuse is OB. Okay, cos theta is base by hypotenuse. So this is base is what it is, OA. Okay, and hypotenuse is OB. Understood? Tan theta is perpendicular by base. What is perpendicular? AB. And what is base? OA. Okay. Similarly, cosec theta equal to 1 by sin theta. Cosec theta, it is a reciprocal of sin theta. What is reciprocal of sin theta is? AB by OB is sin theta. So, hence it is a reciprocal. So, that is OB by AB, because it is inverse of sin theta. Sec theta is a inverse of cos theta, so OB by OA, and cot theta is inverse of tan theta, that is OA by AB. So this is very basic, and these are the trigonometrical identities. We know sin square theta plus cos square theta equal 1, 1 plus tan square theta equal sec square theta, 1 plus cot square theta equal cosec square theta, and these are the values of trigonometric ratio. Sin 0 degree 0, sin 30 degree 1 by 2, sin 45 degree 1 by root 2, sin 60 degree root 3 by 2, sin 90 degree 1, cos 0 degree 1, cos 30 degree root 3 by 2, cos 45 degree 1 by root 2, cos 60 1 by 2, and cos 90 0, tan 0 degree 0, tan 30 degree 1 by root 3, tan 45 degree 1, and tan 60 degree root 3, and tan 90 degree not defined. So these are the values you should know before solving, before start solving height and distance problem. This is very common thing in height and distance. Angle of elevation, you can see this is 0 or OA, which is a horizontal line, and this is a line of sight where we are seeing the some object. Okay. So, and between this horizontal line and this OP, whatever the angle form, that is called angle of elevation. Suppose a man from point O look up at an object P. So from O, a man is looking at object P. Here P is an object placed above the level of his eye. So if you are seeing straight, and the object is kept somewhere in the space, so where the object is kept, that is P, then the angle which the line of sight makes with the horizontal through A, so this is the horizontal from the base where you are standing and from where you are seeing the object. So between your base and the object some angle is formed, that particular angle is known as angle of elevation. Okay, angle of elevation of P, this is the angle of elevation of P from O, that is AOP. Understood? And angle of depression, this is a horizontal line, this is the angle of depression. Suppose a man from point O, this is point O, looks down at an object. In angle of elevation we are looking up, but in angle of depression a man is looking down to the object. Okay, placed below the level of his eye. It is the person is looking below. His sight of angle is below the horizontal. So you can see that below the horizontal. This is horizontal, so it is below the horizontal line. It is level of his eyes. Then the angle which the line of sight makes with the horizontal through O is called angle of depression. So this particular angle is known as angle of depression of P. Angle of depression of which point? Point P, as seen from O. Understood? So based on that, we are going to solve some problem. Two ships are sailing in the sea on the two sides of a lighthouse. Okay, the angle of elevation of the top of the lighthouse is observed from the ship at 30 degree and 45 degree respectively. If the lighthouse is 100 meter high, the distance between the two ships, they ask. Okay, so this is how we are going to proceed. Let AB be the lighthouse and C and D be the position of the ship. See, this is AB where the lighthouse is allocated, and C and D are the two position of the ship. So you can see that this is a triangle. Then AB, we know what is AB, they already given in the question, 100 meter. An angle ACB, that is 30 degree, that is also given in the question. You can see 30 degree. And angle ADB, ADB already given in the question, that is 45 degree. So AB, so this is this particular, there are two triangle altogether, there are three triangle, but we'll take this triangle AB by AC. So AB and AC is one right angle triangle. So AB is perpendicular, okay, and AC is base. So tan, we can use tan trigonometric sign. So tan theta is equal to tan theta, but here theta is 30 degree, so tan 30 degree equal 1 by 3. Understood? So AC can be written as AC equal to AB into this AC equal to AB into 3 cross multiplication. So you will be getting 100 tan 30 degree is root 3. Actually here 3 is root 3 is missing. Actually this should be root 3. This is not 1 not 3, this is root 3. Actually some mistake is there. So this is root 3, 100 root 3, because tan 30 degree value is root 3. So 100 root 3 meter. AB by AD, that is what is AB, this again, and AD is this. So in this triangle, if we see BAD triangle, or you can see BDA triangle, we have a angle 45 degree. So tan 45 degree equal to 1. So AD equal to AB equal to 100 meter, because AB is given as 100 meter as per the question. So we can see CD equal to, what is CD? CD is the total length. Okay, so total length, so CD equal to AC plus AD, so equal 100 root 3. This is root 3. Actually this you should consider as root 3, 100 into root 3 plus 100. So 100 is common, root 3 plus 1. Understood? Root 3 value is 1.73 plus 1, that is 2.73. So we got 273 as a answer. So which is the correct answer? C. So we'll take another problem. The angle of elevation of a ladder leaning against a wall is 60 degree, and the foot of the ladder is 4.6 meter away from the wall. The length of the ladder, they ask. This is very simple question. Let AB be the wall and BC be the ladder. They have already given angle as 60 degree. So this is 60 degree. Then angle ACB equals 60 degree, and AC length is already given in this 4.6 meter in the question. So we can use AC is given, okay, and BC is not given, so we need to find. So to find BC, we use cos trigonometric sign. So cos 60 degree is 1 by 2, so BC is equal to 2 into AC. AC is given 2 into 4.6, that is 9.2 meter. So what is the correct answer? D is the correct answer. This is how you have to proceed with the height and distance problem, with knowing all the trigonometric ratio properly with all the values. of trigonometric sine. So if you will be able to know all those parameters and their values, then it is very easy to solve height and distance problem. So thank you very much for watching. Hope this video is helpful for you.